the quality of a computer's output is determined by the quality of its input. If your subconscious is programmed by chance, its output will have a corresponding character. You have probably heard the computer operator's eloquent term, GIGO, which means garbage in, garbage out. The same formula applies to the relationship between a man's thinking and his emotions. A man who is run by emotions is like a man who is run by a computer whose printouts he cannot read. He does not know whether it's programming, it's true or false, right or wrong, whether it's said to lead him to success or destruction, whether it serves his goals or those of some evil, unknowable power. He is blind on two fronts, blind to the world around him and to his own inner world, unable to grasp reality or his own motives, and he is in chronic terror of both. Emotions are not tools of cognition. The men who are not interested in philosophy need it most urgently. They are most helplessly in its power. The men who are not interested in philosophy absorb its principles from the cultural atmosphere around them, from schools, colleges, books, magazines, newspapers, movies, television, etc. The spread of drug addiction among young people brought up on today's intellectual fashion demonstrates the unbearable inner state of men who are deprived of their means of cognition and who seek escape from reality, from the terror of their impotence to deal with existence. Observe these young people's dread of independence and their frantic desire to belong, to attach themselves to some group, clique, or gang. Most of them have never heard of philosophy, but they sense that they need some fundamental answers to questions they dare not ask, and they hope that the tribe will tell them how to live. They are ready to be taken over by any witch doctor, guru, or dictator. One of the most dangerous things a man can do is to surrender his moral autonomy to others.